All right, good afternoon. Today we're talking about section 6.1, which is ratios and rates. So what I want you to do first is go ahead and hit pause and copy down this information. So go ahead and do that. Well, the first thing that we notice here, it says ratio. It says, what is a ratio? Well, it is a comparison of two quantities by division. So we are talking about, and again, comparing it by using or by division means that you're comparing 1 to 5, and we've talked about with our last chapter with fractions always being a division problem. 1 to 5, 1 colon 5, which also means 1 to 5 or 1 out of 5, or the 1/5, 1 to 5 ratio. Okay, and you've probably seen ratios written. A lot of times you find it on top of a gas can lid or a gas lid on lawnmowers or weed eaters. You also see them. We've talked about if you look on the back of a lottery ticket, like a scratch-off ticket, I know it says it has an actual ratio on it as well, of how many chances you have to win compared to how many cards or lottery tickets you were to possibly purchase. Obviously, you're not purchasing those, but if mom or dad would to buy one, certainly look on the back and you'd see that ratio. Example says count the number of girls and boys in the classroom. Well, we're going to do this example in class and be able to then answer these questions of what fraction shows the part that the girls represent of the whole class. What fraction shows the part of the boys represented in the class, and what would be the ratio that compares the number of boys to the number of girls in the class? So I'm going to go ahead and put in here, let's say we have 10 girls and 15 boys. So what fraction shows the part the girls represent of the whole class? Well, there's 10 girls, and we're going to write these as fractions, okay, being that it says what fraction shows. But it's comparing it to the whole class. So comparing to the whole class, we've got to remember that it's everyone included. So 10 plus 15, you've got 25. Okay? And then yes, you would simplify this by dividing both of them by 5 to get 2/5. Okay? So for every basically comparing two girls to every 5 boys. Okay? Or I'm sorry, I said that wrong. Two girls out of 5, okay? Because this could be, since it's comparing to the whole class, this is out of a possible 5. This could be boys or girls. So if we have 2 out of 5, then the difference for boys would be 3 out of a possible 5, okay? So what fraction shows the part the boys represent in the class? Well, we are going to write 15 out of 25. And when we reduce this, we're dividing by 5 and you get 3/5. And see, as we compare these two fractions, as I was saying earlier, that 2 out of a possible 5, 3 out of a possible 5, we add these together and you get 5/5, which is one whole class. What would be the ratio that compares the number of boys to the number of girls in the class? What would that ratio be? Well, if we're comparing boys, that would be 15, and to girls would be out of 10. And yes, you could divide this by 5 and get 3 out of 2. Okay, so how you would state this ratio would be that for every 3 boys, there are 2 girls. Okay. So these are our ratios. Yes, they're written as fractions, but they truly are not a fraction. They can be written as proper or improper. You would not be simplifying these to be 1 1/2 because we are comparing, again, two different situations to each other. So you would not reduce this. It's just a comparison, and we write them as a fraction to be able to compare. So let's look at our next problem. It says Rate. Well, a rate is a ratio comparing two quantities with different kinds of units. So, for example, $12 for 3 pounds. So it would be $12 over 3 pounds. The unit rate, which is the rate for one unit of a given quantity, would be, for example, since we have the $12 for 3 pounds, we want to know how much it is for 1 pound. So you divide these by whatever the denominator is. So since this is a 3, we divide both of them by 3. If this was a 4, we divide them both by 4. And then that's going to give us this denominator to be a 1. That's what we want it to be. We want to know how much it will cost for 1 pound. And yes, this numerator could, and many times will, be a decimal point, okay, or a mixed number. So don't be surprised if it's not always a whole number. But we want this bottom one to definitely be a 1, because we want it to be equal to what it would be for 1 pound, and that is called one unit, or the unit rate. So let's try some of those. Well, the first thing, it says write the ratio in simplest form that compares triangles to squares. So go ahead and hit pause and solve this. So we're going to, again, comparing triangles to squares. So we're going to go through, and I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21 triangles. Over, and I'm going to change my color so that I can decipher them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 squares. Okay? So again, what they're asking, you can reduce this, definitely can do that and should. So we're going to reduce it by 3 to get 7 fourths, and we're going to leave it 7 fourths. We're not going to do anything to that. And explaining its meaning is simply saying that for every 7 triangles, there are 4 squares. Okay? Let's look at our next one. Write a ratio in simplest form that compares the number of rectangles to the number of shapes. So go ahead and hit pause and solve this. So we're looking at rectangles, and rectangles are the same thing as squares. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay, 16 is what we have for our numerator, and our denominator is talking about for all of them. So if we've got all of them, we can already say we've got 16 of those, and then 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41. Okay? And then, yes, you can certainly double check and make sure that no other numbers will go into this, and they do not. So it is simply saying, again, explaining your answer, is simply saying that there are 16 rectangles out of a possible 41 shapes. Okay? Let's look at our next one. Unit rate says write each rate as a unit rate. Write your answer in complete sentences. So go ahead and solve this. So I have $9 for 3 cases of soda. Okay. And unit rate simply says that we need to make certain that this denominator is a 1 because we want it to be how much it's going to cost per case of soda. So we're going to divide both of them by 3. And so we get 3 over 1. So it's going to be $3 per one case. Okay, so when it says write your answer in complete sentences, you need to literally just write it out and say that it is going to cost $3. Whoops. Per case of soda. That's your answer. Okay. Again, if you're having questions on this, please make note of it and write it down for our class tomorrow. Go ahead and solve this. Again, we're trying to find unit rate. So we have 25 meters. That's my numerator, and denominator is 2 seconds. Okay, so we're going to have to divide this by 2. So 2 divided by 2 is 1. And 25 divided by 2, you can go over here, divide by 2, we get 1. 0 left over, bring down the next number, goes into it 4 times, which is 4. Subtract, and you get 1. And you can say 14 and a half, or you can add a 0 and a decimal, and you see that you get 14.5. meters. Okay, so you would simply say 14.5, or you could have put 14 and one half meters per second. That's your answer. Okay, so again, unit rate, they want you to write it as a fraction, write it as that ratio as a fraction, and then make certain that you divide by whatever that denominator is, because that's going to give you the unit rate. And yes, that numerator could, and many times will, be a mixed number or a decimal. Doesn't matter which method you use. Some of you say, well, you can't have a decimal within a fraction. Remember, these are ratios. They are ratios, not necessarily a fraction that we have been working with in the past. Okay, where you're adding and subtracting them. This is just a way to represent this ratio. So have a great night, and we will see you tomorrow.